day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Early in the morning, late in the evening, I'm getting red dirt rich and Flint River paid. Hunting, fishing, and loving every day. I get a little farm pond buzz, sound of gravel when I'm backing up, pulling a string on a 9.92 stroke Murphy. I love it when my baby wants to roll with me, throws her boots on, climbs in a tree, tucking her hair in my hat, and she's ready.
It's how to catch shiners on pieces of bread. The best bread I find is the inside of a hot dog bun. You just take a little piece of it, that big, and roll it over your fingers. See, I'm going to try another one. Sometimes it takes more. And you want it really small. You want to mash it down so that it kind of looks like it's in the middle. Next, what you want to do is you take something about like this, get the fish jumper. Shouldn't take long. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put my bread on my hook. Just like that. You need a very small hook, a very small weight. And it really shouldn't take long. Might take a couple tries, might catch a couple brims. Just gotta be patient with it. Oh, look at there, a turtle. You know what? We might be about to try to catch this turtle. Turtles are bad for a pond. You don't want turtles in a pond. Sometimes what you might want to do is you might want to fish the outer layers of where you caught your cereal. Or where you threw your cereal. Oh boy, these shiners are big. But the cage is not too small. Alright, so I'm going to try, like I said, try different locations. Right over here. You see up there? Shiners. I'm gonna adjust my depth a little bit more here. And there it goes. See, I told you mine's a little overgrown and being stubborn, but it's all it takes is a little bread.